This is a production of PBS 39.
Many of us bemoan the ever-accelerating race to keep up with technology in daily life. It's either hurry up or fall behind. It's either change or wither on the vine. And yet some of life's treasures only reach perfection through aging. Such is the case with Martin Guitars and the Nazareth-based company that has made them for 175 years. Grover Silcox takes us inside.
What do Mark Twain and George Harrison have in common? They both owned a Martin.
I say to people, if you buy a Martin guitar and you take really good care of it, it's going to last longer than you will.
Gene Autry, known as America's favorite singing cowboy, owned one, as did the cattle roping king of the cowboys, Roy Rogers.
It's really remarkable, you know, the fact that we're still around, we still have the reputation that we do, the success that we do.
This year marks C.F. Martin & Company's 175th anniversary, making guitars for all kinds of people with all levels of talent.
The list of Martin owners reads like a who's who. Eric Clapton, Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, Paul Simon, Tom Petty, Paul McCartney, John Lennon, George Harrison, even Ringo Starr.
Why do guitar players choose a Martin? Chris Martin, chairman, CEO, and great-great-great-grandson of founder C.F. Martin Sr., thinks just maybe the guitar chooses the person.
It has a personality. You know, what I say to people is if they've honed in on a particular model of Martin guitar, try and find a Martin dealer that has more than one of those models, because one may speak to you more than another one.
Martin guitars evidently spoke to Elvis.
This is a commemorative Elvis Presley model. Has Elvis's signature at the 12th fret. Has the stars. Elvis loved the bicentennial Martin guitar that had stars. This has TCB, which is Elvis's little logo, taking care of business.
Perhaps that voice, the singular sound reverberating from each Martin guitar, comes from the way it's crafted.
Well, the process starts with the very careful cutting and acclimating and seasoning and drying of the wood, putting it up on sticks, getting it sanded and trimmed to rough dimensions, in some cases machined to a particular shape. Then brought upstairs where the extremely arduous assembly process begins.
An assembly line of skilled workers and highly specialized craftspeople create each Martin guitar.
The most complex tool we have in the factory is the human hand. And we have more highly skilled human hands in our factory than any other guitar factory on earth.
The first hands to make a Martin guitar were those of Christian Frederick Martin Sr., a furniture builder turned guitar maker who left his native Germany for America in 1833. He set up shop in New York City and shortly thereafter moved to Nazareth, a hilly, wooded location that reminded him and his wife of their native Saxony. It was here that Martin created his Stauffer-style guitars with the curly-Q headstocks and a legacy spanning six generations and extending to many of the world's best guitarists.
Just this week, Jackson Browne has been here. Steve Howe of the band Yes.
Yes, the stars stop by, and also the public at large. They all come to tour the factory and walk through the expanded factory museum.
We've got about 200 guitars on display, so you can follow guitars from 1833 up until the present day.
Check out Martin's 1 millionth guitar on display here, along with this rare model.
The pre-war D45. That is the Holy Grail. We never kept one. We made 91 of them before World War II.
That D45 cost $270,000 to retrieve, just a tad more than the $300 it originally sold for in 1942. The D45 stands alone, but most of the displays feature multiple artifacts divided by era, such as the pivotal 1930s.
The 30s was a period when we had really just begun the transition from gut to steel string. And the steel string is considered the modern guitar.
Other displays exhibit tribute and signature models that also come in production versions for sale through retailers.
This guitar here is the Johnny Cash model. Of course, it's made for the Man in Black, and it's really a tribute guitar to Johnny Cash. He was our good friend and loved our instruments, and we loved him.
For the budget-minded musician, there are Martins under $1,000 and as low as $300. But some limited editions or tribute models like these can go for $8,000 plus.
Martin guitars become more valuable as time goes by. And so does your bank account, but you can't go home at night and play your bank account.
The company plans to throw some special events and to offer certain limited and commemorative models to honor its 175th anniversary, a milestone achieved by making what many call the best guitar in the world.
We have a little questionnaire we send out with our warranty. And one of the questions is, what was your primary influence in terms of you deciding to buy a Martin? More often than not, the box that people check? Friend.
That's the kind of endorsement that has kept Martin Guitar at the top of the charts for 175 years. For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers. And workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39. Thank you.